which type of LinkedIn account is right for you? The free version of LinkedIn, LinkedIn Premium, or LinkedIn Sales Navigator? With LinkedIn Premium, it's not something that everybody needs, yet I get asked the question all the time. So here are some of the features of LinkedIn Premium. You get 15 in-mail credits per month. This means you can send 15 messages to people that you are not connected to per month. And this gets reset at the end of every month. You also get unlimited profile views, which means that you can search to your heart's content, you can fill your boots, and you can do a lot of LinkedIn stalking. This is a great feature if you are doing a lot of prospecting and market research on LinkedIn. Not everybody needs this, and LinkedIn doesn't actually tell you what the monthly searching limit is. So if you're just getting started with LinkedIn and you are unsure if you're going to be doing that many searches, just try it out and see if you reach your searching limit before the month is over. Because if you do, it will be reset on the first of that month. You also get your 90-day profile viewing trends with LinkedIn Premium. This means that you can see everybody that has looked at your profile over the last 90 days. It's a very handy feature, and I personally really like this feature because it tells me if I'm attracting the right sort of people for my business to my LinkedIn profile. However, if this is the only thing that you're interested in, I don't recommend it. You're not getting a huge value for your money, but it is something that's useful as part of the package. You also get detailed company insights, which means if you go to the LinkedIn, if you go to somebody's LinkedIn company page and scroll down, if you have LinkedIn Premium, you get access to company insights, recent hires to that company, growth trends over the last 3 and 5 years, income trends, recruiting trends, and it just helps you build up a picture of the sort of company that you're looking at. So if you're in a sales role or a market research role, this feature can be very, very handy. You also get access to LinkedIn Learning. Now, LinkedIn Learning you can access outside of LinkedIn Premium and it will cost you a lot less. And it is a great platform and you can access lots and lots of different training videos and training courses from trainers around the world. I actually think it is pretty cool. But again, it's up to you and it depends on what you're using LinkedIn for. So if you are doing lots and lots of profile searches per month, then LinkedIn Premium is a great tool and it's something that would be worth your money. Whereas if you just want to see who's looked at your profile over the last 90 days and you're not really sure how many people you're searching for per month, I really recommend that you just try out the LinkedIn free version and just see if you reach your limit and you do need to upgrade. Don't just go straight in with a LinkedIn free account, or rather the free trial of LinkedIn Premium, because if you don't need it, you're not going to take advantage of that free trial. So wait until you've identified a need and then try it out. LinkedIn Sales Navigator, on the other hand, is for people that really want that real detailed targeting. It's a separate platform to LinkedIn, so you have a different inbox and it's a different way of working. I only really recommend that you go down the LinkedIn Sales Navigator route if your role is predominantly sales. Personally, I can get by with my CRM system or my own sort of sales management tool on Trello and just using LinkedIn Premium for prospecting. I've found in the past that that has worked absolutely fine for me and I've not needed LinkedIn Sales Navigator. However, I do know a lot of people that use Sales Navigator and have that benefit from it. Again, they do offer free trials of this, so if you're keen to try it out, then try it out. But I do recommend just trying the free version first, seeing how that works for you, then trying LinkedIn Premium, seeing how that works for you, and then only if you think you need Sales Navigator, go down that route too. I hope this has been a helpful video. If you do have any questions about the differences between LinkedIn Free, LinkedIn Premium, or LinkedIn Sales Navigator, drop a comment below and I'll help you out. Ciao for now. See you later.